Welcome to Signal and System lecture series. Here in this session, I'll be discussing continuous time and discrete time signals. So let us begin this session with first point, that is, what is continuous time signal? Now see, continuous time signal, that is a signal which is having values at all time intervals. So a signal which is defined for all values of time is called as continuous time signal. So as if we consider some examples, then we can understand, like, see, if signal is having values at all time interval, then it is continuous time signal. So there are some basic examples like sine wave, which we already know. Like, see, if I have a sine wave that is having magnitude varying in between plus A to minus A, so one can observe here at all time instant there is value, so this signal is continuous time signal. Let us have one more example so it will be more clear. Like, see, if you have a square wave like this, which is having magnitude that varies in between A to minus A, so that is even a continuous time signal, where one can observe values of amplitude with this signal that is there at all time intervals. Now let us see what is discrete signal. So a signal which is defined only at discrete time intervals, so that is discrete signal. So whenever you have a signal which is having value at discrete intervals, so that is what discrete signal. So for discrete signal, usually we do sampling process, and after sampling one can have discrete signal. So for that I'll give one example. Like, see, if you have this sine wave, right, and to have discrete signal in sampling, all we do is we multiply impulse train, we multiply impulse train with this signal, and that results into discrete signal. So if you multiply this discrete signal with this continuous signal, means this impulse train, when you multiply this with continuous signal, that will make this signal into discrete signal. So what will happen is, like, trajectory of envelope, that will not change. So trajectory of envelope, which was sine, which we have seen, so that will be like this only. But as you multiply this impulse train, you will be having values at discrete intervals only, so you will be getting discrete signal like this. So this is what discrete signal. Now one thing that we need to note here, continuous time signal, that we denote it by x of t, and discrete signal that we denote with x of n. Now let us move on to how we can represent this continuous time signal and discrete time signal as a function. So when you represent this continuous time signal, as we know, this is what sine wave. So sine signal, that we can note it down as it is having amplitude A. So A sine omega t, where phase is zero. So I'm just writing it A sine omega t. If it is having any phase, then we need to write it as A sine omega t plus phi. But here phase is zero, so we can note down this signal as A sine omega t. While over here for a discrete signal, we can note down this if this is having amplitude varies in between plus A to minus A, then we can say this is what actually A sine pi n, where n is what number of samples. So if I say here this is zeroth sample, first sample, second sample, So this n shows value of which number of sample that is available over here. And this spacing in between this samples, that is based on sampling frequency. So when you do sampling at a time, we define what is the interval in between two consecutive samples. So this is what discrete signal. Now I'll discuss few basics. Like say discrete time signal. In discrete time signal, time is discrete and amplitude is continuous. So this is what discrete signal, where time is discrete, right? We have fixed samples at particular position 0, 1, 2, 3. But here you can see amplitude can be anything in between this range. So amplitude may be anything, one can say it is continuous, but time is discrete. But when we talk about digital signals, so in digital signals, both time and amplitude both are discrete. So all we do is, in digital signal, first we do sampling, so we'll be having discrete signal, and then after we do quantization. So after having quantization, we don't have fixed time interval, we will be discretizing amplitude even. So after having quantization, you will be having amplitude as well as time, which is discrete one. So digital signal is having time and amplitude, which is discrete one. So this is all about continuous time and discrete time signal. So these are the basics that one should understand. Continuous time signal, that is having value of amplitude at all intervals, while discrete time signal, that is having value at discrete time intervals. And for a digital signal, amplitude as well as time both are discrete. See, to get discrete signal, we need to do sampling process where we multiply impulse train with continuous signal, that makes signal into discrete one. And to get digital signal, we need to do quantization process. So after having quantization, we will be having time as well as amplitude, which is discrete one. So this is about continuous time and discrete time signal. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely, based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.